Hi, I'm Mike Watt.
I'm Dan Storm, and we're working on the Deer Project in Southwest Wisconsin.
We're here to talk today about clover traps. It's a tool that we use for catching whitetail deer. It's a big part of our project that we're doing currently, and we want to let people know a little bit about them. So this trap is designed in such a way that deer will walk in, they'll come into the bait, and there's a trigger line, which we'll show in a moment here, but basically there's a trigger that comes across, and when they bump that trigger, this door right here slides down and shuts, and the deer is captured at that point.
They're a little bit more portable than the other methods, so what we'll do is we'll have a bunch of these out in sort of a trap line along a road or a trail on a property, and we're able to put these apart, you know, several hundred yards apart, and then we'll just drive our route, drive the trap line, and check them one at a time. First of all, they're staked to the ground so that they're fairly stable. The deer can't bounce around and knock the trap over.
Knock the trap over, definitely. They have what are called, we call them breakaway bars on the side. So with the trigger assembly, the way this is designed is if the deer does kick around and bump around these bars, instead of being solid and something that the deer can get hurt on, they actually break loose and fall to the side, so there's no risk to the animal.
And this is where the trigger is actually attached to.
Right.
And so these are collapsible traps. And so if we have an antlered buck, we're trying to restrain that buck. So we're going to cut these cords, and we'll gently let the trap collapse, and so that'll kind of restrain the buck in that way. Then we can drug it.
Yep, exactly. So
another safety feature here.
Yeah, we have what we call a spider wire. It's a made-up name, basically, but these are, what we've done is we've put a piece of rope in here and wired the netting in such a way that the deer bouncing around cannot hit these poles.
Okay, this is what we're talking about. We're talking about the spider webbing. We take the netting on the side of the trap and the netting on the back, and we join it together, and then we loop this rope through it that ties these ends together. And it will do the same thing on the top. And the purpose of that is when the deer bounces around when it's first caught, it's gonna hit that. It's not gonna hit the metal pipe. So it's a safety feature for the deer. And what's gonna happen is, so the deer gets caught, they trip the trigger, this will slide down, it makes noise, and they're just gonna get startled, so they jump. And so the point of this, again, is when they do that, they're gonna hit net, not metal. A thing that's been happening down here is we've had squirrels and rabbits come in. They like corn, just like deer like corn. And so they'll come in, and instead of nicely walking out the front of the trap, they're always gonna chew their way out. So every time, this is a little bit of a safety hazard, so every time our crew comes and checks the nets, they're gonna repair all these holes every time.
First thing we do, we've got the bait in here, but we've got to run a trigger wire across that'll actually operate the device. And the way it works is a nice tight string here, and we've got a wire that hooks to this that operates the net. And the way we want to do this, we want to set it in such a way that it's tight enough that when they hit it, it'll pull the trigger, but not too tight that it'll just trigger in the wind or something like that. So, and the next step is to take, and I'll face this way so you guys can see, but this is a pretty simple mechanism. You just take the main rope. So what we do is we take this rope that goes straight to the door, we put that underneath the cotter pin, and then Dan is holding the door for me there. He's going to put the weight of the door down on this cotter pin. So now the weight's pulling up and over the trap to the door, and now it's holding steady. And the last step we do is we try to get this trigger nice and light. The tension should be nice and tight across here. I can do a little bit of adjustment to try to tighten that up, and that's how we want it. And now it's triggered and ready to go.
Okay, so we've got the trap triggered, and so what's gonna happen now is the deer's gonna come through the trap, they're gonna go after the bait. The bait's just sitting behind the trigger, so they're gonna nudge the trigger with trigger rope with their nose or their leg. And the deer's caught. That's it.